Our topic is heart defects congenital and acquired. Congenital is hereditary, acquired during the life. Heart defects in the heart. Heart defects means a problem in the walls of the heart mainly and in endocardium. So we have to remember some laws about the heart. First law, that the hemodynamic of the blood, it's coming from up till down. It means from veins, then atriums, then ventricle, then arteries, aorta and pulmonary artery, from up till down, the hemodynamic of the blood. Next law of the heart, that the pressure in atrium, the pressure in atrium less than in ventricles. It means the pressure in ventricles more than in atrium. And next law, that the pressure in left side of the heart more than the pressure in right side of the heart. This is some laws to understand heart defects. Heart defects, as I said, could be congenital and acquired. Congenital heart defects, the most famous is ASD, atrial septal defect here. It's still opened between two atriums. VSD, between ventricles, still opened. And there is Fallot's tetralogy, tetralogy of Fallot's, and ductus arteriosus. Very short, I will tell everyone. This is the famous, but there is also multiple heart defects due to some congenital disorder during developing of the fetus during pregnancy. But anyway, ASD, I said, it's opened window between atriums, so the blood will be shifted from left atrium to right atrium. Left atrium blood is oxygenated and will be mixed with deoxygenated blood. This is how the blood will be shifted. And why from left to right? As I said, that left side is more pressure than right side. VSD opened also window between left ventricle, right ventricle. The blood also will be shifted from left side to right side. The same oxygenated blood will be mixed with deoxygenated blood. Ductus arteriosus, we know that aorta and this ischemical picture, but in our body, the aorta and pulmonary artery, they are like this as a crossed vessel. Aorta, pulmonary artery, they are crossed, and between them, in some cases, it will still opened between aorta and pulmonary artery. We call this ductus arteriosus. The blood will be shifted from aorta to pulmonary artery. It means oxygenated blood will be mixed with deoxygenated blood. So this is the most common congenital heart defects in the heart. ASD, VSD, tetralogy of Fallot's, and ductus arteriosus. And how the blood will be shifted, I already said. Manifestations of these pathologies, hypoxia, because as I said, that oxygenated blood will be mixed with deoxygenated, means that our body will not be fully supplied with oxygen. About acquire during the life. Acquire, it could be due to some diseases, and the famous disease in this side is rheumatoid fever, rheumatism. It started with tonsillitis by beta hemolytic streptococcus group A, causing tonsillitis. And then by allergic reaction, third type immune complex, our immune complex is transported with blood, and then it's reached to the heart and adhesed to our valves of the heart. Could be these valves. Then it causing damage in the heart. So the acquired heart defects is commonly there are two types: stenosis, and regurgitation. Regurgitation of the valve. Stenosis or regurgitation. Stenosis means that the valve is narrowed, not opened fully. Regurgitation, the opposite. It means that the valve is opened, it cannot closed fully. So stenosis means the valve is narrowed and cannot opened fully. Regurgitation means that the valve is dilated and it cannot closed fully. In both cases, it will leave this opened area. And why, when the blood are coming through this area, this open area, causing murmurs. So the murmurs, heart murmurs, due to the blood flow during this narrowed opened area, whatever its stenosis, when the valve cannot fully opened, or regurgitation when the valve cannot fully closed. In both cases, we will leave this opened area and blood coming through this flow that through this area and causing murmurs. So according to these two pathologies, stenosis regurgitation, acquired heart defects could be mitral stenosis, mitral regurgitation, tricuspid stenosis, tricuspid regurgitation, aortic stenosis, aortic regurgitation, pulmonary valve stenosis, and pulmonary valve regurgitation. This is the most common acquired heart defects, mainly in valves. Now it will be easy to understand how hemodynamic disorders will be acquired in these types of pathology. For example, let us take mitral stenosis. While the mitral valve is localized between left atrium, left ventricle, the blood will be congested here because it cannot fully cross this to left ventricle. It will be congested here. Then it will lead to hypertrophy of left atrium. Then the blood will be congested in lung veins. Then congestion in lungs, then lung edema. In mitral regurgitation, the blood will be flowed to left ventricle, but in systole, when the left ventricle want to pump blood to aorta, this mitral valve must be closed, but it will be open because of the regurgitation. Then the blood will be flow back to the left atrium. Then congestion left atrium, then left the lung vein, then lung edema. About tricuspid regurgitation, tricuspid stenosis, the same. The blood cannot, in first one stenosis, blood cannot fully flow to the right ventricle, it will be congested here in right atrium. Then congested in vena cava inferior, then leg edema. In tricuspid regurgitation, blood can flow direct to right ventricle, but in systole, the blood will be flow back because it's opened. It's weak, opened. And then congestion in right atrium, then in vena cava inferior, then leg edema. How to remember where is edema will be acquired in heart in valvular disease, heart disease. How to remember? Yes, I. You can remember like this: left heart and right heart. Left lung, LL. Left lung means if it lifts a side heart problem, so lung edema. R, right heart root. Root means legs. Root, leg edema. So left heart, lung edema. Right heart root means leg edema. It's easy to remember. Where is edema will be acquired in case of congenital heart, in case of heart defects or valvular heart disease. About aortic stenosis, aortic regurgitation. When aortic is stenosed, so the blood will be congested in left ventricle, but the pressure here more than here. In the future, the blood will be shift back to the left atrium, then congestion left atrium, then lung congestion in lung veins, then in lung, then lung edema. About aortic regurgitation, the blood will be can get out to aorta, but so sorry, aorta has arch pressure more, then the part of the blood will be shifted back to the left ventricle, then left atrium, then lung. Remember please that aortic stenosis in the future leads to mitral regurgitation. Aortic stenosis in the future can lead to mitral regurgitation because the pressure high and all the time it's press mitral valve from inside. About pulmonary artery, stenosis, the blood will be pressed here more, then the blood in the future will be congested in right atrium, then vena cava, then leg edema. Regurgitation, the blood will be also two direction, to pulmonary artery and back to right ventricle, then in the future right atrium, then leg edema. You have also to remember that about valves, we have inside heart valves, inside heart mitral tricuspid, and outside heart valves. They closed and opened oppositely, opposite relation. In systole, the heart tried to push the blood from its side to outside. It means that aortic valve and pulmonary valve opened in systole. Then in this time, mitral valve tricuspid will be closed. So in systole, aortic valve, pulmonary valve open, mitral tricuspid closed. The opposite in diastole. In diastole, aortic pulmonary closed, mitral tricuspid opened. Why? Because diastole we need to fill the heart with blood. So we need to open inside heart valves. Again, systole to push the blood from inside heart to outside heart. So we need to open aortic and pulmonary valves and close the mitral tricuspid. Diastole, we need to fill the heart with blood. So close aortic pulmonary, open mitral and tricuspid. If you remember this, it will be easy to understand murmurs. Systolic murmurs, diastolic murmurs. This is in general about heart defects. Thank you very much.